basic sponge. That was not, in fact, what happened. And people keep talking about how this is infecting employment, but employers are not allowed to ask if you've had a charge. They can ask if you've been convicted, but they can't ask if you've had a charge. So we want to get to the bottom of what all of these real problems are. We did have several expunctions. We do have several on hold, and that's pointing out the problems that we've had. We want to solve the problem.
Members, Representative John, General Director.
Just a comment to follow up on the previous comments from my colleague from Gilbert County. Not only are we moving the football, it seems to be we're canceling the game with this proposed bill. And I likewise would be voting down.
Members, the chair has several folks signed up for public comment. At this point, is there any further discussion or debate from the committee? Representative Clemens, the lady's recognized.
Thank you. I just want to add that when we passed the Second Chance Act, it was after Representative Hardister and I actually worked on it 4 years ago, and it was after a tremendous amount of diligent work and bipartisan compromise. So it's disappointing to see us moving backwards after a unanimous vote with a tremendous amount of listening across the state to all different kinds of people to come up to a compromise. And it makes me sad that we would move backwards on something that has such commitment from such a broad range of people. Thank you.
Is there any Representative Dixon?
Nice, Representative Stevens, your question.
Yes, sir.
Notwithstanding the fact that we passed this in the manner we did, you're saying that with that we have identified X number of problems that need to be addressed, and it's not totally discounting what we did, but there, by experience, we've run into some problems.
Thank you. You're exactly right with that analysis, that these are problems that when you had a petition you could file, the judge could take those into account. We didn't take them into account. We didn't look at other ways that we would need to use this record.
I have a question for Representative Stevens. The expunctions are for, not for guilty charges. So no one's been found guilty and their record has been expunged. The expunctions are for dismissed charges and not guilty charges. Thank you.
Representative Dahl.
I have just a point of clarification and or a question. So listen up, it might be a question. So I understand there are problems, but it sounds to me like there are problems by certain counties. And it seems to me like we're stopping production in order to fix some problems. And so I'm a little bit confused as to why we're doing it. We're not allowed, as employers, we're not allowed to ask about somebody's record, but we can pull their criminal record background and it comes up there. And I can't tell you, as an administrative assistant office manager, how many letters I have written so people could get employed or people could get apartments because their not guilty status was on their record. And that concerns me that we're stopping some of those lighter charges. I mean, NC State, I don't think those men over there, I'm not sure they'd have a place to live if we didn't. I mean, that's what I did, is I wrote letters from a lawyer's office saying these are not guilty charges. Because people, the normal folks out there who don't practice law and don't know the courthouse, don't know how to read a criminal background check. So this is a great concern to me because I think it's going to halt a lot of people's progress. And I wish if we need to correct problems, I wish we could correct problems that were defined and identified within this bill and also given a time frame. Because I feel like if we're going to correct an issue, we really need a time frame so that people know that we as the state legislature are not going back on our word. We're taking a little pause, but we have a timeline and we have to stick to that time. So,
Representative Stevens, ladies recognize.
Thank you. It is not just in a few counties, it's in all counties. There are offenses in which the district attorney will dismiss with leave in an effort to try to get a prosecutor there. He'll dismiss with leave because they won't come to court. He'll find them later. Now, talking about delays, as 565 came over here, it was going to give them 6 months before they would dismiss the case anyway. If you file this petition, which costs nothing, it's a form, and you submit it to the court, this bill provides that it must be dealt with in 90 days, which is certainly quicker than 6 months or a year. So, you know, that I'm still trying to leave some relief out there, and I'm still trying to help identify all of the problems. It was amazing that they came to me with 3 pages of problems that we can try to work toward resolving. So it's not an issue of going back on our word. It's trying to move forward in a responsible way.
Representative Clements.
Yes, I just wanted to make the point that no one here is saying that that has been without fault. The point to me is that the solution of Senate Bill 565 gave the solutions that a broad range of people, again, across a wide diverse perspectives, work together on solutions to the problems risen, and that was voted on unanimously. This does not have that same approach. And I wish that we would stick with the approach of Senate Bill 565 that is informed across the state and across broad perspective and had unanimous support in the Senate. Thank you.
Further discussion or debate from committee members on the bill? Hearing none, at this point, we'll move to public comment. Some members and those who are public commenting, you'll have up to 1 minute to speak to the bill. The chair will just, we'll start with Daryl Atkinson. Chair would ask them, each member of the public, you will state your name and if you're here on behalf of an organization, who that organization is, and then speak to the bill for up to 1 minute. Gentleman's recognized.
Thank you, committee members. My name is Daryl Atkinson. I'm a lobbyist with Forward Justice. I know this issue intimately, both intimately, personally, and professionally. I've been a practicing lawyer in North Carolina for 15 years, filed petition-based expungements in probably over 50 different counties. And over that period, I saw a real disparity between people who could afford a lawyer and get this kind of remedy and people who could not. In 2019, all of you all made a promise to North Carolinians that wealth wouldn't be a distinguishing factor of whether you could get a second chance in this state. We passed the Second Chance Act, which included automatic expunction for not guilty and dismissed charges. Not anything that anybody was convicted for, not guilty and dismissed charges. With any piece of legislation, major legislation, you're going to have implementation challenges. And we did. And AOC, by statute, convened a working group with all of the relevant stakeholders, the people who are closest to these issues, to come up with solutions. And Senate Bill 565 is just that. And it passed unanimously 46-0. This PCS is taking us backwards, not forward. We would encourage you to vote against it and keep Senate Bill 565 in its original form.
Members, we'll move now to Laura Webb at the NC Justice Center. We'll give you a second to come up. You will just tell us your name, who you're here on behalf of, and speak to the bill for up to 1 minute. Ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning. My name is Laura Webb, and I'm with the North Carolina Justice Center. I am here today to urge this committee to vote against any effort to do a permanent repeal of automatic expungement. Over the last decade, the Justice Center has worked with many of you all to advocate for the expansion of access to expungement, including the Second Chance Act in 2020. We were appointed to the working group and worked in good faith with stakeholders across the state, including the Conference of DAs, the clerks, SBI, the DMV, private attorneys, and the Sheriff's Association, and all the stakeholders agreed with the recommended fixes that were the original version of Senate Bill 565. What we know when we look at other states like Virginia that have both automation and petition-based expungements is that it is the combination of both that assures that everyday people have access to the expungement relief that they are otherwise eligible for. It is reinstating automatic expungement with the recommendations from the AOC working group that will ensure that North Carolina, more North Carolinians get back to work. Thank you. We ask you to vote no on the repeal of automatic expungement.
Members, will move now to Christy Puckett. You will come up, tell us your name, who you're here on behalf of, and speak to the bill for up to 1 minute.
Hi. First of all, thank you, Mr. Chairman, for allowing public comments today. My name is Christy Puckett, and I represent the North Carolina Second Chance Alliance and For Justice. I also represent people living with the stigma of having been harmed and having engaged in harm, because none of us exist in one context, and all of us deserve the opportunity to expand and grow. 16 years ago, I was in a highly abusive relationship with a drug trafficker, and I was actively substance using myself, engaging in behaviors to support my substance use disorder. I was being harmed and engaging in harm. Support made a difference for me, which is why I can stand before you today in my full power and able to be fully involved in my community. We need policies that submit the community supports I received, reflect your understanding of the complexities often faced by your constituents, and address the complex issues they face. There are enough barriers to jobs and housing without this body creating more. Do not walk back the promises that you made to us. Delay is a denial.
Rayla Collins. Well, tell us your name, who you're here on behalf of, and speak to the bill for up to 1 minute.
Rayla Collins, ACLU, North Carolina. So I just want to start by saying the concerns expressed are what led to the pause and the forming of the working group. They were accounted for by the working group, which issued recommendations that became 565 in the Senate. These concerns would be addressed by lengthening the processing of automated expunction from nearly immediately in the original bill to 6 months after the disposition of the charge, and allowing DAs and clerks and defendants to still have access to expunged records. Those were the fixes in 565, among with some others, but, oh Lord. So we ask that instead of repealing automated expunctions, adopt the fixes that were incorporated in the Senate's version of 565 and allow automated expunctions to restart, fulfilling the promise of the Second Chance Act.
Keisha Millett, you will approach the microphone and state your name, who you're on behalf of, and speak to the bill for up to 1 minute. We'll give you a second to get up here. Lady is recognized.
Good morning. My name is Keisha Millett. I am a staff attorney with the North Carolina Justice Center. I ask that you vote against Senate Bill 565. I have represented and heard from a number of North Carolina residents needing an expunction. The need is so great that the petition-based system, while helpful, is wholly inadequate. Even with current services from legal aid, private attorneys, and local clinics, it's impossible to make sure that more than a fraction of those who are eligible for an expunction are actually able to obtain one. We have automation here agreed upon by stakeholders as a practical solution for a very real problem. Every county represented in this room has residents who are seeking work or housing and are discovering that a dismissed or not guilty charge is showing up on their record and blocking them from moving ahead with their lives. I have even heard from a dear community member who reached out to me with dismay that it's a dismissal was keeping her from getting a qualified sitter. Thank you so much. Please restart automation.
Cedric Williams. We'll Strike that. Sorry, that's a different bill. We'll move on to Whitley Carpenter. We'll approach the microphone, tell us your name, who you're here on behalf of, and speak to the bill for up to 1 minute. You're recognized.
Hello, my name is Whitley Carpenter. I'm with Forward Justice and the North Carolina Second Chance Alliance, and I'm asking today that you keep the North Carolina Second Chance Act alive by not repealing the automation of expungements. We were a part of the group of stakeholders in the working group with advocates, with district attorneys, with clerks, with the AOC, and according to the primary bill sponsor, Senator Danny Britt, I quote, basically anybody impacted by the practical implication of what the automatic expungements did was involved in the drafting of the legislation that made it into 565 as filed. In that group, we addressed district attorney access to expunged records. We addressed how destroying files nightly was harmful. We worked out all of the identified problems with automation, but our solutions were never given a chance. Instead, we were surprised with a full repeal on a policy that everybody in this General Assembly voted in favor of. 400,000 expunctions in the 9 months that this bill was in effect, now less than 5% of the people impacted by automation since that time have been getting relief. That shows that the petition process is not simple, it's not easy, and it's not working. Please don't renege on the promise of the Second Chance Act. See it through. Thank you.
Members, those are all the members of the public. The chair has signed up to speak to the bill. Is there any further discussion or debate from committee members on the bill? Representative Quick.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I just wanted to, it was alluded to earlier that there would be no cost in the petition system. It may not be any cost to file the petition, but there are soft costs that impact real people. It costs to take a day off work. It costs to get a babysitter. It costs to go through the process of petitions. And we've got evidence, 400,000 North Carolinians received a second chance in 9 months based on the unanimous promise that we made. We enact this bill, we're kind of taking away from a second chance. It's not a second chance. It's like a 1.5 chance. And if you go through the petition process, it becomes a second chance. Let's please not do this. We've got 1.2 million North Carolinians who are waiting to get on with their future on not guilty and dismissed charges. I think that's very important.
Is there further discussion or debate from the committee on the bill? Seeing none, Representative Stevens moves for a favorable report to the PCS to Senate Bill 565, unfavorable to the original bill. All those in favor will say aye. All those opposed, no. Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The bill receives a favorable report. Representative Stevens, I think you have, Chair, believes you're handling Senate Bill 303 as well. And there is an amendment. The lady, you want to start with the amendment?
That will be fine.
Okay. The Representative Stevens recognized to send forth amendment CSSA-47. The lady's recognized to speak to the amendment.
What this amendment does is we were talking about who else could qualify as a magistrate, and it could be someone who was a law enforcement officer. And then we wanted to clarify, it said in a county, but we just clarified it's in the state. So highway patrolman, city police, county police, anybody who served as a law enforcement officer for at least 8 years, I think that's right, at least 8 years experience as a law enforcement officer could be nominated to be a magistrate. That's what the amendment does.
Members, the chair understands there is a PCS on this bill. So without objection, that PCS will be before the committee. So ordered. Further discussion or debate on the amendment? Hearing none, Representative Stevens moves for adoption of the amendment. All those in favor will say aye. All those opposed, no. Ayes have it, and the amendment is adopted. We're now back on the bill. Is there further discussion or debate on Senate Bill 303? Seeing none, Representative Stevens moves for a favorable report to the PCS for Senate Bill 303. As amended, rolled into a new PCS, unfavorable as to the original bill. All those in favor will say aye. All those opposed, no. Ayes have it. The bill receives a favorable report. Senate Bill 124. Members, who's carrying Senate Bill? Representative Stevens, the lady is recognized to speak to Senate Bill 124.
Yes, and this will be one of my, as my husband will call this, would be one of my lesser presentations because I will read to you what was given to me. In insurance rebate reform, this is the NCOIL model language agreed upon by the insurance industry and has been adopted across the country. It modernizes North Carolina and allows users and agents to provide products or service to their clients that are currently prohibited by state law. It also allows carriers and agents the opportunity to provide innovative service and technology to clients that will potentially help to reduce claims and provide more efficient service on our end. A couple of examples are security tools, smart home devices for customers, and anti-theft tools for auto insurances. These anti-rebate laws were created a long time ago and haven't been modified. It brings North Carolina up to the 21st century. Don't know of any opposition to it. The second one is a bill that is, the second part of it is the predatory roofing contractors. We have passed that in the House twice before. This is Dean Arp's baby. It basically does two things. It provides homeowners with a 5-day window to cancel a roofing contract if the homeowner's insurance is denied when there's roofing damage. And that may be typically the result of subpar work for unlicensed contractors. It prohibits a roofing contractor from collecting payment from the homeowner until that 5-day cancellation period is over, except under certain emergency situations. I want to emphasize that this is intended only to capture the folks that come in after a storm and prey upon our friends, families, and constituents. It contains an exception for North Carolina general contractors and for retailers like Lowe's and Home Depot. And that's it.
Members, is there discussion or debate on the bill? Seeing none, Representative Stevens moves for a favorable report to Senate Bill 124. All those in favor will say aye. All those opposed, no. Ayes have it. The bill receives a favorable report. Members, we'll move now to House Bill 900. Representative Perret, the lady is recognized from her seat to speak to House Bill 900.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Committee, House Bill 900 provides for the continued recognition of the Wake Young Men's Leadership Academy and the Wake Young Women's Leadership Academy as a cooperative innovative high school. This is an agreement between Wake County Public Schools and the State Board of Education, Department of Public Instruction. This will provide for an expedited substitution of a new higher institution partner. And this is needed because of the accreditation issue with St. Augustine University earlier this year. This is a bipartisan bill, and I know of no opposition. I ask for your support.
Members, Chair does have one member of the public signed up to speak. Are there any other committee members who wish to speak to House Bill 900? Seeing none, the chair will move to public comment. And as we did on the last bill, the member of the public will have up to 1 minute to speak to the bill. Cedric Williams, you will approach the microphone and tell us your name, who you're here on behalf of, and speak for up to 1 minute to House Bill 900.
Thank you, sir. As mentioned, my name is Cedric Williams, area superintendent with the Wake County Public School System. Have a member of our school board here as well, Sam Hershey, along with one of my colleagues, Paul Domenico. And we're here just to ask you to be in favor of this bill that will allow continuity for our students as we search for a new partner. Unfortunately, had some issues with St. Augustine's, and we've moved from St. Augustine's and in search for a new partner. This will allow us to immediately get a new partner so that our students can continue with their process and education of being involved with an early college. Thank you.
Members, is there further discussion or debate on the bill? Seeing none, Representative Perret moves for a favorable report to House Bill 900. All those in favor will say aye. All those opposed, no. The ayes have it, and the bill receives a favorable report. One moment, committee members. Members, that is mercifully the end of today's calendar. And without further business being before the committee is now adjourned.
There you have it. Today at the NCGA, that was, I joined a little bit late, that was the rules, calendar, and operations of the House meeting. Again, the North Carolina General Assembly does not archive their meetings. They live stream them, but they do not archive them. So based on my time and funding and availability, I try to do that with this Today at the NCGA segment. You may learn more on the state's website, and here is their agenda for today. When I joined, they were discussing amending the expunction. So you heard that about SB 565 and other bills and public comments as well. Stay tuned for more details as they develop. Please subscribe to anniedance.substack.com if you haven't already. I greatly appreciate your support as I work to shine a light on police and policy issues in Western North Carolina and beyond. Thanks for watching. See you next time.